So typically in a presentation, it's best to design or to put together your outline first. In that way, your message will flow, the content will flow. The next step is to enhance the presentation. Obviously, you can use the designer feature to enhance the slides in your presentation. But also, you can insert here all kinds of other objects as part of your presentation in order to make it more visually appealing. It's not a matter of just throwing a whole lot of stuff as part of your slide and demonstrating that you're a great designer and you know all kinds of things to insert. The idea is to sell your product. And the idea is to emphasize the point that you are making through the use of graphics or content as part of each of your slides. We go here under the Insert tab and notice you can insert other slides, you can insert tables, pictures, shapes and icons and 3D models. And this is where the latest version of PowerPoint really has advanced. And then you can insert videos and so on. So I'll cover each one of those components separately, but for now, I'll just focus primarily on inserting graphics. Now those graphics, you can insert them from the web, or you can insert them from clip art as part of the computer. So if we go here under pictures, notice you have from this device, stock images or online pictures. Typically, if you wanted to just get an image from the web, we can go to the web here. So let's say this is one of the images from the web that we want to copy. We right click on it, we choose copy. Then we come back to the PowerPoint and then right click anywhere in your presentation and choose paste. Now notice here you can resize this. And then as you're working with this image, if you double click on it, notice that the picture tools or the contextual tools related to images show up on the top. So notice we have the different picture styles. We can change and remove the background, change colors, transparency, and so on. And notice you have these different various styles that you can apply to this image that we just inserted from the web. Of course, you can change the border style, the shadow and the glow and all kinds of other settings. So it's just a matter of you tinkering with this. And notice you can change also the layout of the actual image to different types of layouts as well. One important concept in PowerPoint and any of the Office products when you're working with images is also the crop feature. So notice on the right-hand side, this image, it extends quite far, and it's just an empty space here. So let's say we wanted to cut this part here on the right-hand side. We can select the image, you can double-click on it, and then click on the crop icon on the top. Now at this point, we can move the handle here on the right-hand side and bring it more toward the left. We can adjust the other handles as well if we wanted to, and then press the crop icon again. Now that the image has been cropped, we can resize it as necessary. Provided you have the latest version of PowerPoint for Microsoft 365, notice that on the right-hand side, as soon as we enter an image, you also have the designer tool. The designer tool is identifying that your slide has a bunch of bullet points and also images in it, and it's recommending various layouts to make this slide more visually appealing. So to apply one of those designs, all we have to do is simply select any of these designs, and notice it will reformat all the components within that slide accordingly and automatically. If you like this video, please press like, subscribe, and then click on the bell icon.